Some people like the aroma of this plant and some don't. And we need to know that because we...
Well, hello there, I'm Green Dean, and welcome to my 128th video here at eattheweeds.com. This time about the Chenopodium embrodioides, also called epazote, Mexican tea, though it's really an infusion, not a tea, wormwood, though it's not wormwood, but it has been used to get rid of worms, and Jerusalem oak, but it has nothing to do with Jerusalem or oaks. Botanists have also given this plant about 10 other names, Latin names or scientific names, two within the last few years, including Teleoxys embrodioides and Dysphania embrodioides. Let me translate about this plant. What happens is some botanist becomes an expert and thinks the other guys have all got it wrong. So he changes the name. One guy likes goosefoot, fruit of the gods. Another guy likes pointy leaves, fruit of the gods. And yet another likes obscure flowers, fruit of the gods. Well, that's kind of iffy. Here's what I find interesting. The original name is Chenopodium embrodioides, which means goosefoot, fruit of the gods. But every time a botanist changes the name of the plant, he gets rid of the genus name but keeps the fruit of the god part. The problem is, most folks who smell this plant don't think fruit of the gods. They think kitchen cleaner of the gods. Most people describe the aroma of this plant as one of three things. Some, usually with ancestors from Northern Europe, think it has a citrus aroma. Some from Southern climates think it smells like sparvaner, so some kind of industrial chemical. That's the group I'm in. And perhaps the largest group, some people can detect both aromas, kind of a lemony turpentine. But one thing's for certain, once you can identify the aroma, you'll have no problem identifying the plant, no matter what they call it. What bothers one man's nose is an excellent spice to another man's palate, and thus the use of the embrodioides. It is a spice, and very common in Hispanic cooking, and as you might guess, it also has many medicinal uses. You know, no one ever need buy this spice. It grows everywhere. While it's native to Central America, you can find it everywhere in North America, except the very northern plain states next to Canada and the provinces just above that. I need to tell you, this plant also comes with a warning. In my classes, I've had two people have an instant reaction to this, allergic reaction to this plant. They were people who knew they had allergies and were being careful. One student smelled the plant and her lips started to tingle and then went numb. That effect lasted for a few minutes, but there were no other symptoms. Another student smelled the leaf and her ears began to ring immediately. That lasted for a few minutes and was also the only symptom. As a spice, it's fine. The oil in stronger concentrations can be used to get rid of worms in people and animals, and in stronger concentrations can kill you. So this is a spice. If you're going to use it herbally as something other than the spice, you need to consult an herbal expert. Here in Eat the Weeds, we itemize. Let's itemize the Chenopodium embrodioides, the epazote. And we start with identification. It's an herb that grows to about 40 inches high, somewhere around that or 4 feet. The leaves are lance-shaped and toothed, very toothy. The leaves, flowers are small and green. Seeds are very, very small, green when fresh and black when dry. The plant has an extremely strong odor. And that should remind you of something like cleaning paintbrushes, at least it does me. Think of it as an ugly lamb's quarters that smells bad. Time of year. In Florida, year-round, or in any type of warm, southern warm environment year-round. The rest of the year farther north, it is a summertime plant. environment. Waste grounds, dumps, fields, railroads, roadsides, trails, oh, abandoned fields, usually in a dry area, but it will respond to irrigation and get very, very tall and leaf out. Method of preparation. You can use the leaves and flowers as a spice. They're best used fresh, but they can also be dried. They're used in soups and salads and meat dishes. The most common use, however, is in bean dishes as a flavoring, and also it reduces noisome gas. In other words, they put this in beans as a flavoring, but it also reduces flatulence. It's a hot day here in July. Thanks for joining me on my 128th video here in Eat the Weeds, this time about the Cynopodium ambrodioides, or goosefoot food of the gods. If you want to know more about the plant, visit my website. I'm getting close to having 1,000 plants there. And I'm also hoping to have a new website up fairly soon. And yes, we're still working on developing a TV show. Oh, and if you want my newsletter, please send me an email address. There's one other thing. As I mentioned, this is July, this is what, 2011, and my videos have now passed the 1 million views mark, and I'm in excess of 12,000 subscribers. Who would have thought our esoteric topic would ever been so popular? Thank you. Until next time, this is Green Dean, and I want you to think green, even some smelly green, eat green, well, as a spice only, and live green too. Toodles.